Now to look at the McDonald's starting lineups in the East. Carter, O'Neal, and Wallace up front. McGrady and Iverson in the backcourt. You see the West with Garnett, Duncan, and the 7'6" Yao Ming, Kobe Bryant, and Steve Francis. And Kobe, plus the injuries suffered by Kobe, Shaq, Carmelo, Rick Fox. Off the glass. And Vince Carter puts it down.
Opportunity coming up here, and Allen Iverson knows he's got Carter trailing, so he just lays it up off the backboard. There's Vince to finish it off.
1 points for the West have come on second chance points.
Allen Iverson averaging, throwing one off the glass. Here's Iverson putting it up.
Well,
there's no question that both teams got serious down the stretch, and the West has defeated the East 136 to 132. So the West has now won four of the last five. Shaquille O'Neal, 24 points.
Just a little over an hour and a half ago, Allen Iverson arrived to the pyramid. The answer will start. With a win tonight, the Memphis Grizzlies will guarantee themselves their first ever winning season. It's a 41-25 Memphis Grizzlies against the 28-39 Philadelphia 76ers. And we begin with the visiting Philadelphia 76ers. Aaron McKee, Kenny Thomas, 11 straight double-figure rebounding games. Samuel D'Alembert in the middle out of Seton Hall. Allen Iverson, yes, he will start. And Eric Snow.
You have two very effective players on your team at playing defense and taking care of the ball.
High off the window, Iverson. Allen Iverson attempting to operate here.
Iverson moving well without the basketball. Curls all the way around, two picks.
By Philadelphia. Thomas in Detroit was held to 8 points, although he did have 10 rebounds. A steal, number one of the NBA in that category, and Iverson right to the hole.
You have to be careful and know where he's at, because he's playing for the Steelers. He's not a great one-on-one defender, but he's an easy basket.
Remember, this is a team, when you take a look at it, what they've done over the last week as Iverson connects. A shot, no call. And Gasol coming up slowly as he was knocked in the throat, and at the other end, Philadelphia executes. It's 43-34. And the Memphis Grizzlies climb back, trailing by 13. And the Grizzlies come away with the victory, 82-79. And Hubie Brown heads over to Chris Ford. Two old school coaches having a quick word. And his team has now guaranteed themselves of a winning season. Hubie Brown has answered that question.
For the past 2 years, Philadelphia has ushered the Hornets out of the playoffs. This season, Baron Davis is trying to will his team to a fourth seed and home court advantage in the first round, while Allen Iverson and the Sixers are currently on the outside looking in at the postseason field. Tonight, BD and AI square off in a matchup of two of the best in the business. Hornets, Sixers, game on!
Baron Davis hopes that 46 minutes last night weren't too much to sap his strength for this battle tonight with Philadelphia, while David Wesley sees opportunity in four games of five at home. Allen Iverson's role with this club, he's a starter. He made that clear earlier this week. Eric Snow tries to keep the glue together on a ship whose wheels are about to fall off. Welcome inside New Orleans Arena, where tonight Cox Sports Television is proud to present New Orleans Hornets basketball. The Hornets play host to the Philadelphia Philadelphia 76ers.
Controversy, but we decided whether he'll be with his club again next season. He had 8 turnovers last night, Steve. He averaged 4.3 per game. The Hornets can ball hog him a little bit tonight.
He's got senior.
Back to Iverson. Hornets in a zone. Thomas gets in the middle of it, turns. Iverson drives and off the glass just in time as the shot clock expired. He
put already this game.
Up on the wing, Iverson steps in, fires the shot. Simply smooth as Allen Iverson ties it. Hoffman playing aggressively. Thomas boards the miss. Ahead for Iverson. Iverson has a trailer. D'Alembert, and his jumper is good. D'Alembert with 4.
Wow.
The Hornets trail Philadelphia and Allen Iverson by 2. There's a nice Allen Iverson pass that D'Alembert will finish. And that's the margin of difference right now. Yeah, D'Alembert in a very bad place.
Sliced him up.
Sliced, diced, chucked and hurled. Iverson from the corner. He's got 9.
Assist for it, but he should.
West with 4 points already. Here comes Iverson down the lane. Little pass to Kenny Thomason. He'll score his first over through it. Coleman recovers. Here comes McKee. Iverson on the wing, and he'll finish. Allen Iverson with 11.
That comes back again. Here comes Iverson. They set the corner screen. Nobody jumps out to McGlure. On the break. This is what Philly is so good at. Good defense, and then they...
Players goes reverse off the glass. Nothing happens. Long court pass on the fast break. Iverson. Crowd says he walked, but 76-64. They were down by 9. They're now up by 12. It's a 21-point swing.
A lot of time, though, you know, Steve.
Yep, and Iverson.
And an AI around.
Yeah, delivers a message that it's not
supposed to a pool.
Snow off to Iverson. Iverson on the wing with the drive and the score. Allen Iverson. 17-8. Can't tip the miss. 4 three-pointers in the fourth quarter eliminated the Hornets from the playoffs in the 1999-2000 season. And Allen Iverson gets the jump shot job, but that's a franchise that is reeling.
Has he given him any indication he wants it?
Time runs out on the Hornets with a convincing win. A rousing rout of Philadelphia. The Hornets outscored the Sixers 47-18 in the final 16 minutes of play as they defeat the 76ers and even the season series. They pick up their 36th win of the season against 32 losses.
Well, it would be a great day for a little beach time, but very little time for sun and fun with an NBA playoff spot to be won. And here at the American Airlines Arena today, tickets at a premium. Everyone wants to see the answer, Allen Iverson. And can the Heat take the next step in their pursuit of a playoff spot? UBN 33, TVX 34 bring you Heat Sixers basketball for the 4th and final meeting this year.
This is Eric Snow, the co-captain and veteran point guard. Iverson from the corner.
Call that a transition basket because they float into it. It's not numbed.
Matinee Saturday, it's a big one here in the Eastern Conference. Eddie Jones defending Allen Iverson. Knock it down for Iverson, who does average just over 23 field goals over the last 5:45. Alston got a hand on it. This is Iverson, the open look for 2. Bottoms up for Iverson, who now has 8 points to go along with 3 steals. Rasul for 3. And the rebound to Samuel D'Alembert with a Heat up 9. Iverson on the floater, bottoms up. So 10 points for Iverson. That makes 55 straight games. Done with great defense through these first 2 quarters. Iverson and a pack of Heat defenders. That's a beautiful play as Samuel D'Alembert smashed home his first field goal. D'Alembert with the rebound. Brian Grant back in the game. He sits down Udonis Haslam. Iverson triples. Allen Iverson with... Miami has outscored Philadelphia in this quarter 27-8. Iverson got the bucket plus the foul. Well, you can only hold the irrepressible Allen Iverson for just so long.
You know, at the end of this drive, it's Iverson who actually makes a move to step into Brian Grant to draw this contact. There, Right there, you see him move to his right, shoves the elbow and shoulder into Grant. That's why Grant looked at the officials and said, what do you want me to do? I'm standing here. He went out of his way to hit me, but smart players know how to draw that contact.
Brian Grant's second foul. Iverson leaded by 15. Ivy's biggest lead, 16. That came late in the second quarter. Iverson alley-ooping for D'Alembert. And the dunk plus the foul. Yes, Allen Iverson can do more than just score. Beautiful setup. Step closer to making the playoff dream a reality. Miami's 32nd win of the year. Their seventh straight at home. The Heat have now won seven of their last eight overall. And today they do it with an emphatic fourth quarter, outscoring Philadelphia 30-10 in the fourth quarter. Now, the last time the Heat were within five games of 500, it was back when their record was 15-20. Warren Sapp back in his Kareem Abdul-Jabbar jersey. But with Sapp wearing his Wade jersey, the Heat ran away with this basketball game.
Historic Cologne, Germany, on the banks of the Rhine River and inside the Köln Arena. The U.S. may not be home, but they're not without their home fans. Many Americans on hand wearing the red, white, and blue as the United States gets ready to play the second game of its six-game pre-Olympic tour tonight, taking on Italy. And for the United States, Stephon Marbury and Allen Iverson in the backcourt. Lamar Odom and Richard Jefferson starting at the forwards, and Tim Duncan in the middle. Duncan with 12 to shoot. That's a two for Iverson. And the kick out picked off by Odom. Up ahead is Iverson. Allen Iverson with his second field goal. He's on a run. They have scored five in a row leading to this timeout, and they're back to within eight. Jefferson, Iverson, the shot clock at 10. AI finds the bottom. Seven. Off the loose ball, Allen Iverson finds Wade. And Dwayne Wade has his first points of the game.
Italian Federation, located in Rome, just an hour's flight from Athens.
And the Americans get a three-point hit. Anthony with a touch to Iverson, who's got the straight-on three. And Nacional Italia will celebrate now. A 17-point win. It was never in doubt in the fourth.
And all the things. Still second in the tournament in rebounds despite only playing 26 minutes a game. Iverson. Good pull-up from Allen Iverson. Lithuania's lead is four. It's their largest lead of the game. Iverson squares up for a three. Allen Iverson now. Duncan looking for the ball. They are surrounding him. Allen Iverson. That's a three for Iverson. And the USA regains the lead. Iverson down the other end. Allen Iverson wide open, puts it in. And for the United States.
The United States have come in here tonight with a very workmanlike professional performance, and they're going to take the bronze home.
So for the U.S., what's been a disappointing Olympics will end with this strong performance and that bronze medal. Larry Brown congratulating the Lithuanian players. And this is what you wanted to see from Team USA after what's been a rough couple of weeks, three losses, their chance for gold out. They came back, played hard, and played well to beat a team that beat them a week ago.
Yeah, how disappointing it must be from Lithuania. They got a great draw. They got China in the quarterfinals, and they beat them handily. Thought they were going to beat Italy.